Deciding how to run your application code in the cloud can be difficult. You have a variety of options and probably many dependencies and requirements, and it all seems so complicated. Well, my name is Mandy, and I'm here to show you that it's actually not as complicated as you first thought. There are two main ways to run your app in the cloud. Infrastructure as a service, which gives you maximum flexibility by providing virtual machines in the cloud. Or platform as a service, which provides fully managed software stacks to which you can deploy your application code, but which has a more restrictive environment in terms of supported languages and features. This is a tough choice, and one that we had to consider when building the Google I/O WebRTC Code Lab application. This is a simple demo application that allows you to use WebRTC, which stands for Web Real-Time Communications, to perform peer-to-peer real-time streaming between multiple clients. While the app wasn't complicated to build, there were some complex requirements unique to the application that we had to consider when choosing between infrastructure as a service and platform as a service. Because we just wanted to focus on the code and not worry about all the other stuff, we really wanted to use Google App Engine. The main function of this app is to allow users to connect to the server and create rooms, which another user can also connect to. The two users can then stream data to each other. The JavaScript Socket.io library is extremely popular and is well known for simplifying the development of networking for real-time applications. It looked perfectly suited for the task as it has all of our requirements covered. App Engine supports applications written in Python, Java, Go, and PHP. But how can we use it to run Node.js applications? Well, it turns out that App Engine has this cool new feature called Custom Runtimes. Custom runtimes allow you to define your own runtime stack. As an example, a runtime stack could be the Node.js interpreter, using npm for package management, and running your application code. App Engine takes care of provisioning virtual machines, which are then used for building and deploying your runtime stack onto. You also have the option to define health checks that App Engine can use to monitor the health of each running instance of your stack. Because custom runtimes allow you to build and run your own runtime stacks, you can not only run Node.js code, but you can run Ruby on Rails and Perl too. In fact, you can run anything that will run on a standard virtual machine and which can respond to HTTP requests. Best of all, in many cases, you can run your existing application code on custom runtimes without modification. One of the coolest things about working with custom runtimes is that they are really similar to how App Engine already works. If you're not familiar with App Engine development, you basically develop your application code, pull in any dependencies, and supply a configuration file that provides metadata which will be used by App Engine to deploy and run the app. You can also factor large applications into logical components called modules. Modules within an application share state but have their own performance settings, with each module having its own configuration file. Our WebRTC application has two modules. One is for the front-end component that handles incoming requests and is a standard App Engine autoscale module. The second is the custom runtimes module, written in Node.js and which does all of the heavy lifting via the Socket.io library. The first step towards deploying the example app is to place the application level and module level configuration files alongside the application code and its dependencies. We then need to provide some configuration for custom runtimes, and this comes in the form of a Docker file. Custom runtimes are actually Docker containers running on fully managed compute engine virtual machines. Docker containers are portable, lightweight virtual machines that allow code to run in isolation from other containers, but at the same time safely share resources from the host machine. The Docker file defines the configuration of a Docker image and can reference another image which you can use as the basis for a new image. In this example, that's all we're going to do. But you can define more complex images via additional commands in the Docker file. Now, when you deploy to App Engine with Cloud SDK, it takes care of building the required Docker images, as well as creating and managing the containers and the virtual machines needed to host them. Once deployed, your app is immediately ready to start serving requests. It's really that simple. You can manage and monitor your running application through the developer's console, as you would any other App Engine app. And you can also see the status of the managed virtual machines that are running the Docker containers that run your application code. Behind the scenes, App Engine does all of the work to keep your code running, including monitoring instances and checking that they are healthy. Custom runtimes make it easy to run Node.js applications in the cloud, And because you don't have to worry about managing systems and software stacks, you can spend more time writing code, or even using all the time you save for a well-deserved vacation. Go here to find out how you can get started testing with custom runtimes and go to developers.google.com/cloud for more information about Google Cloud Platform. Thanks for watching. Now go out and build something amazing in the cloud.